So the big question is this: how are commercial real estate brokers like us, who didn't take on debt to start their own brokerage, who are stuck in the hamster wheel of day-to-day selling, how do we sell real estate and build our businesses in a way that lets us develop rockstar teammates and create enough leverage to back away from day-to-day selling? How do we get our services, ideas, and insights out into the world and yet still create passive wealth? That is the question, and this podcast will give you the answers. My name is Brett Swarts, and welcome to the Expert Commercial Real Estate Secrets Podcast. I'm so excited. Leka, and I'll let you pronounce your last name because I'm going to butcher it. Welcome to the show. How are you doing?
Good. It's Leka Devatha, and thank you for having me, Brett.
Excellent. So excited to dive in. So would you give our listeners a little bit about your background and your current focus?
Yes. So as you said, my background, you know, was in fashion merchandising. I moved to the country in 2006 and had a very successful career at Nordstrom Corporate. And but, you know, towards the end of that journey, I want to say, I discovered real estate and I made a full switch to investing, you know, eyes closed, open. I don't know what to call it, but it was a big jump. And I, you know, bought my first property to flip a couple of months after I left my corporate job. And then since then, I've done dozens of fix and flip. I have done land subdivisions, additions, 1031 exchanges, and then started, you know, focusing on just putting together my rental portfolio. So it's been an incredible journey. And, you know, where I'm at right now, I'm just focused on getting small multifamilies, like 2 to 4 units, and buying, rehabbing, renovating, refinancing those. So exciting so far.
Absolutely. Love it. I can't wait to dive into your full story. But this one, we're just doing a little short episode and we're going to dive into the full episode. So this is kind of the teaser episode. And we're focused on this thing called capital gains tax. We're kind of passionate about that and helping people to defer that. And so as a part of that, though, people want to hear stories from folks who are in the trenches, who are doing deals. So what's the biggest frustration you've had when it comes to capital gains tax deferral options?
Okay, so I, like I said, I'm, you know, I did fix and flip, right? So I flip about, I don't know, 5 to 10 homes a year. And they're all short-term capital gains. And it's really painful to see a big chunk of basically your paycheck going to taxes every time you do a deal. Like right off the bat, like first, when I first started, I realized soon that I would make a massive profit. And then a third of that would just, you know, go into taxes. So that, I think, is my biggest pain point, is that you do so much to find the deal, to rehab the property, to sell the property, and all the little pieces that go into it, and then a massive part of your paycheck's gone, right? So yeah, that's my pain point.
Gone forever, right? Your business partner was the government all along, Leka, and you're doing all the work, and you're doing all of the risk, and they say, hey, 30 to 50%, depending on the state, depending on where you're at, depending on the depreciation capture.
Yeah.
Also, it's ordinary income, right? Because it's short term. It's less than a year.
Right.
So it's like, oh, really painful. So if I'm hearing you right, you've paid a lot of money in taxes over the years that perhaps you wish there was a better way.
Oh my God. Yes. Yes, Brett. I really do wish. Go ahead.
Why not do a 1031 exchange, Leka?
You can't do 1031 exchanges on flips.
Well, some people don't know that, right? So walk through, why is that?
I don't know, Brett. Why is that?
Okay, I'll tell them. Okay, well, so you, I thought you might know. So the reason is because it's not considered long-term, right? So long-term is only for a year or greater. And since it's a year or less, it's considered short-term. So the 1031 exchange is not eligible.
So is it 1 year or is it 2 years?
So I guess it depends on who you're talking with. Okay. And where, okay. What it's, you know, so I've heard at least a year. I've heard some folks say 2 years. Generally speaking, we found at least 1 year or greater that you've held it for. And then likewise, if you do another 1031 into a property, you need to hold that property for a year or greater too. So yeah, be cautious there. 2 years, you're definitely safe. 1 year is a minimum. Yes. So that's where the deferred sales trust is a great option, right? Because you can now use the deferred sales trust for short-term rentals to roll it all into the next deal. And then what's cool, Leka, is let's say you did 5 or 10 deals, and let's just say you paid $500,000 of tax over 10 deals over a year. Well, what's neat is you can move all of the equity and all from all of the proceeds into this trust, as well as deferring all of that $500,000, and then you can use that as a base to fund your next deal. It's kind of like a self-directed IRA. It's kind of like a go fund yourself. It's kind of like your own bank, right? Although you're not borrowing from the trust, you're using the trust as the funding source to buy the next deal on a JV partnership. But it's really amazing because it's all tax deferred. So we just did a deal in Alabama, $2.6 million sale, and the client was owing $600,000 of tax. Now they're selling their business. It was a zero basis, and their goal was to develop apartments. And so they sold the business, did not use a 1031, used a deferred sales trust, and then they using those funds right now to fund their development, all tax deferred, of 80 units in Tennessee. And so it's really, really elegant, beautiful way to keep the money working for you rather than paying the tax and it's gone forever. Is that making sense?
Yes, that is amazing.
So with that being said, if folks want to get in touch with you right now in order to learn more about what you do and what you offer, and we're going to dive into the full interview here in a minute, but what's the best place for them to find you? And are you bringing in investors, or what services do you offer for other folks?
Yeah. So you can first find me on LinkedIn or Instagram. My handle is just Leka Devatha, my first and last name. I am constantly seeking lending partners, you know, private money lenders, because I buy a lot of deals. And where I am, Seattle, Washington, our acquisition and rehab costs are about $1 million. So when you're doing 5 or 10 of those, you know, it's expensive, and I'm bringing capital partners all the time. We find a way to work with each other, find the best way to work with each other, and everything's looked over by an attorney, whatever. So now we do partner on most of our deals.
Beautiful. All right. So reach out to Leka to find more about that. And with that being said, if we can help you selling any highly appreciated asset and are looking for deferred capital gains tax on a primary home, public stock, private stock, cryptocurrency, or real estate, reach out to us at capitalgainstaxsolutions.com and look for the full interview to drop here with Leka. And we so appreciate everyone listening again. Thanks so much. Bye-bye. You have just listened to another information-packed episode of Expert Commercial Real Estate Secrets Podcast with Brett Swarts. We hope you enjoyed today's show and found it valuable. Visit expertcresecrets.com to access the show notes and to access more resources. That's expertcresecrets.com. Don't forget to leave a review and join us again next time.